Hi, everybody, and welcome to our fourth Sunday of Advent. I am wearing my absolute favorite sweater. It says, Happy Birthday, Jesus. So it's a little crazy and wild, but it is our fourth week of Advent. We've talked about hope, peace, last week, joy. Today is love. And I'm going to use the example of a present to talk about this idea of love. So see, I have some presents under our tree ready for the birth of Jesus to happen, celebration of that, by giving each other gifts. But here I have a gift, and I wonder what could be inside. Any guesses of what might be in here?
Shout them at the screen right now if you have an idea.
Let's see. Oh, yep. Maybe candy. You heard that? Maybe a book? No, I don't think so. It seems kind of small. But it's waiting. I wonder, should we just dive in and see what it is? I taped this box too. It is, quickly, snacks! We have some goldfish, we have some biscotti cookie crackers, we have some fruit. It's snacks! Okay, but here's the deal. Love, the love of Jesus, is not something that we sit around and we wait for. It is a gift to us, but it is something that we go to, we engage in. We serve a God who wants us to do life with God and to follow the example of Jesus. And so I'm gonna light our candles today, again, representing hope, peace, joy, and then finally, love. I'm going to use this candle to light it today. And love. And then we will save the Christ candle. Join us for Christmas Eve at 5:30 on Thursday evening. We'd love to see you. You can join us on YouTube or on Facebook. But we'll light the Christ candle. And we'll all light our own little candles at the end of the service and sing Silent Night together. It's going to be so fun. I can't wait to see you there. But as we talk about this love, I'm going to read a portion of scripture that's very familiar. We're going to retell the story of when the angel Gabriel came and talked to Mary and came and talked to Elizabeth and how they talked to each other and how Mary was so ready to receive this gift of Jesus. So before we do that, I'm going to say an opening prayer, and I want you to, like we've done every week, after I say a phrase, I want you to say, our God loves us with Kaisley, okay? Let's pray together. When the world seems scary or uncertain,
our God loves us.
When things aren't as they should be,
our God loves us.
When we make mistakes or other people mess up,
our God loves us.
When everything seems just right with the world, our God loves us. No matter what and all the time,
our God loves us.
We can love God and we can love each other because
our God loves us.
Last one. Today, we light the candle of love because our God loves us. Let's pray. Thank you, God, that you care for us. Thank you that you love us always, no matter what. May the candle of love be a reminder today and every day throughout this Advent season, that you love us and invite us to show others your love. In Jesus' name, amen. Today's story comes from Luke chapter 1, starting in verse 26. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to a man named Joseph of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary, and the angel came to her and said, "Greetings, favored woman. The Lord is with you." But she was deeply troubled by this statement, wondering what kind of greeting this could be. Then the angel told her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. Now listen, you will conceive and give birth to a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give him the throne of his father David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and his kingdom will have no end." Mary asked the angel, "How can this be, since I have not had sexual relations with a man?" The angel replied to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you,
and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the Holy One to be born will be called the Son of God. And consider your relative Elizabeth. Even she has conceived a son in her old age, and this is the sixth month for her who was called childless. For nothing will be impossible with God. I am the Lord's servant, said Mary. May it be done to me according to your word. Then the angel left her. In those days, Mary set out and hurried to a town in the hill country of Judah, where she entered Zechariah's house and greeted Elizabeth. When Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the baby leaped inside her, and Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit. Then she exclaimed with a loud cry, "Blessed are you among women, and your child will be blessed. How could this happen to me, that the mother of my Lord should come to me? For you see, when the sound of your greeting reached my ears, the baby leaped for joy inside me. Blessed is she who has believed that the Lord would fulfill what he has spoken to her." And Mary said, "My soul praises the greatness of the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior, because he has looked with favor on the humble condition of this servant. Surely from now on all generations will call me blessed, because the Mighty One has done great things for me. And his name is holy. His mercy is from generation to generation on those who fear him. He has done a mighty deed with his arm. He has scattered the proud because of the thoughts of their hearts. He has toppled the mighty from their thrones and exalted the lowly. He has satisfied the hungry with good things and sent the rich away empty. He has helped his servant Israel, remembering his mercy to Abraham and his descendants forever, just as he spoke to our ancestors." And Mary stayed with her about 3 months. Then she returned to her home.
How old are you?
8.
Levi, what's your favorite Bible verse?
John 3:16.
How can people pray for you today?
That I hope my school gets done, and I hope my teacher will do good stuff. in school.
Okay.